VT, is anyone in VT?
VT?
I can't see the point in Christmas tapes.
What are you having?
Usual. Cameras, who's on cameras? Keith on one.
5 minutes to transit.
Harry on two. Rod on three. Martin on four. Fine. Okay. That's Rod on four. Martin on three.
Fine. Thank you. That's another 14 pints of bitter, please. A large whiskey. Four double Bloody Marys.
Oh, come on, Errol. Don't be so boring. Come and have a game of snooker. You won't get anywhere reading that load of old rubbish.
Ridiculous game, if you ask me. I'm reading a very interesting book here. The object of Erasia is to remove any remnant flux.
Oh, shut up, Errol!
Anything else?
Yeah, you better put another vodka on the hamster's leek juice.
Forget the vodka, I'll just have the leek juice.
You draw me around a twist. Yeah, absolutely brilliant. Wouldn't you agree, Rip Fains?
Help, this. It's got 2 minutes. Yes, I should give you a few words. This is Sam Double. I am Anne Diamond. I'm sitting here. It is 6:21. I'm not quite sure of the date. Oh, I was mistaken. Thank you. Good morning, Pete and Sam.
Why do Vinci editors always walk around in threes?
Hey, what about your edit?
Ah, oh, fuck the editors. Why do Vinci editors always walk around in threes?
10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6.
Errol! It's 25 past six, you idiot! Run VT!
All right.
Good morning, and welcome.
You're about to watch one of a series of video. Start again, from the top. I beg your pardon.
Clear the boom. I'm not starting with that booming.
Wet, but apart from that, we'll do our best.
Okay, let's see if we can get the Nolans involved as well. John, thanks very much. And he's not there, really.
Well, I am here, actually. I'm just waiting for, you know, there's a mass scramble of cameras. Hello, hello. Where are we now? Are you there?
Yes, well, you have to say nice things about Greasy and Law.
Oh, he was Chelsea.
Greasy and Law, because they're still here. It is interesting to wonder about how, I mean, my...
good show, isn't it?
It's very extraordinary to stick his hand up your back.
I can remember as far back as when Michael Parkinson used to use a microphone.
The heart of man corresponds to the nucleus of the cell. Extract this, and the man dies. The sun is the heart of the nucleus with the solar system. Obliterates, and the planetary system would disintegrate. And gone!
So don't forget, rub-a-dub-chub on Sunday. See you then, fuck it.
Sorry!
All right.
Sorry! Go back! Just go back! Can we... Oh, fuck. Fuck it. Fuck it. Oh, bollocks.
Now, this cucumber costs over 30 pence, and it's a nice straight one. This one costs 20 pence, and it's much bigger, I think much tastier looking.
Wait, if that were really thinly sliced, you wouldn't ever know it was a crooked cucumber.
No, so look out, they're called crooks and bents in the trade, so look out for crooks and bents. The cameramen are laughing at me.
I don't know why people are laughing so much, Lynn, really, to be honest, but, I mean, that is incredible.
Yes, this is quite a good specimen.
It is indeed. Martin, do you think we could have a look at yours?
I blush to produce it.
Letter from cucumber lover, Mrs. Brooks from East Grinstead, wrote in to say, if your cucumber's going limp before you can eat it, and I heard this has happened to Wincey on occasions, you put the stalk in water.
Did you read that yesterday, Nick? I mean, I never read those shitty papers anyway.
Dulcie de Falsi, travel agent. Oh, that's interesting.
They'll be in capable hands here, Roland, and I nearly forgot your name then.
Do you want me to speak coherently? I'm talking fucking like a bunny.
Riz, can you get... Go on, nip him. We're taking a gag shot. Go on, nip him.
Would you not see a freezer a day before cracking them?
Ooh, that sounds very painful.
Put your Brazil nuts in a pan of cold water. Boil them for 1 minute, then plunge them into cold water.
Oh, I have a marvellous time, you know, in the water. And I bet you didn't know. I bet you didn't know I could also do impressions. Hello, Rat fans.
Roland Rat?
No, Sir Geoffrey Howe.
Mrs. Thatcher is now seriously considering raising the whole question of diplomatic immunity at the meeting of the Vienna Law Commission next month. Okay, that's for level. Under the Vienna Convention, at the moment, the police were not able to enter the siege because the... Take it again. Under the Vienna Convention, the police could not enter... Can we move? I can't hear a thing. Mrs. Thatcher is now thinking seriously about raising the whole question of diplomatic immunity when the International Law Committee meet next month.